Hello, this is IPU and Lorena Saldierna Gomez. And we were talking in regards of the virus that is causing damage to the community. And as we were talking in that regard, hola, le estamos diciendo que estamos aquí en el International Pentecost University y su servidora Lorena Saldierna Gomez para platicar en lo que corresponde a lo que le está afectando a la comunidad, que es el virus, coronavirus. We were remembering, estábamos recordando some people, alguna gente, that they used to live, que vivían with us, around us, alrededor de nosotros. And that for some reason, y que por alguna razón, they made up their minds, ellos decidieron to move away from this place, para irse a otro lugar. And for whatever the reasons, whether, por cualquier razón, tal vez because the weather was not good for them, tal vez porque el tiempo no era bueno, right? The environment, tal vez el ambiente. Whether because they had done something wrong, porque tal vez hicieron algo malo, and they had to go away from embarrassments. Tal vez porque hicieron algo malo y se tuvieron que ir antes de pasar tantas vergüenzas, ¿verdad? But really, the education is there, or us. Y en serio, que la educación está ahí for everybody, to teach each one of us, para enseñarnos a cada uno how to improve our lives, cómo mejorar nuestra vida, how to make less mistakes probably, y cómo hacer tal vez menos errores, like these people were embarrassed, right? Como esta persona, ¿verdad?, que había pasado por circunstancias, and they were really ashamed of themselves, right? Y ellos realmente tenían pena por ellos mismos. So, but why is that these people were in this kind of behavior? Pero ¿por qué esta gente se encontró en esta clase de conducta? Was because they were very healthy and they have more than energy to do all kinds of things. Era porque tenía mucha energía y tenía que ir a hacer otras cosas más. Was there because they were ill and nobody knew. Era porque probablemente estaban enfermos y nadie supo. Right? How come is that these people who were not interested in going to the school were suffering all these kind of things, right? ¿Cómo es posible que esas personas, ¿verdad?, que realmente no les importaba ir a la escuela, sufrían de enfermedades, right? Sometimes we call them social illness. Algunas veces les llamamos enfermedades sociales, right? And then we were saying, right, as we were remembering all the people that are not here with us anymore, y a como estábamos nosotros recordando las personas que ya no están con nosotros, right? Whether if they passed away, whether if they decided to move to another country. Ya sea que esas personas murieron, o ya sea que esas personas se fueron a otro país. But the truth is, pero la verdad es que we cannot find any explanation. No podemos encontrar explicación. Why? Right? If the school had plenty of food, 2 meals a day, si las escuelas tienen 2 alimentos al día, all the way to high school, to hasta que terminan la prepa, if they have plenty of homeworks to fill in, Si les dan bastantes tareas para que ellos hagan en clase, back those days, allá en los tiempos antiguos, you have to write so many notebooks of so many things, so many times, and you have to go through books and notebooks and notebooks and paper and pencils, and you never get enough of pencils and pens and notebooks. Back en los tiempos antiguos se tenía que usar tantos cuadernos, tantos plumas, tantos lápices, bastantes, nunca te dabas abasto en tantos cuadernos que tenías que escribir, muchas cosas que escribir, right? And nowadays is different. So what is happening, right? But anyways, we were saying, right, and we agree that living in this country, right, it's very important to be prepared, right? In the educational ways, right? In order to face this kind of situations, right? To prevent. Prevention is the better cure. It's a better medicine to find somebody or to have to take somebody into the surgical room in order to take a piece of them. Piece of their bodies, which is very essential for their lives, right? And in order, ¿verdad? En para prevenir y a manera de prevención, vemos nosotros que la educación, right? Education, it comes into a very important pace, right? And place, right? Y decimos que la educación viene a formar parte de la vida de. Because you can just practice every single thing you learn at school. Y puedes practicar todas las cosas que tú aprendes, right? You can bring the agars, you can bring the McConkey, you can bring the food that is just to grow whatever microorganism around your house, around the garden, in the kitchen, in the bathroom, when you feel that you walk into a place and eventually it's hitting you, right? You feel, the human body have a sense to tell you, have a way to tell you. Le digo que es tiempo, ¿verdad? Que todas las cosas que se aprenden en la escuela las podemos practicar. El agar, ¿verdad? El McConkey. Los petri dishes que practicamos, que compramos para hacer los exámenes en la escuela, ¿verdad? Puede poner para prevenir, porque es mejor prevenir, ¿verdad? Que es la mejor medicina que hay, la prevención. La prevención es lo mejor que hay antes de llevar a las gentes al quirófano para poder quitarles un pedazo de usted mismo, right? And we say that in this country, we have to be prepared with all the knowledge available in each one of our homes in order to find out what is happening in our homes and to protect our homes, right? And to do the things that are supposed to do in order to find out and see the risk, right? That our house and our siblings and ourselves are going to get engaged when we live in an environment like ours, right? Y decimos que todas las cosas que aprendemos en la escuela, ¿verdad? Se practican alrededor para mantener áreas saludables, para poder detectar hasta dónde llegó, ¿verdad? La enfermedad, la contaminación, ¿verdad? Cómo se le puede hacer las medidas de prevención, ¿verdad? Para proteger su casa y para proteger sus familiares y usted mismo. And we see, right, that it's not really hard to acquire, ¿verdad? A ways to organize. Y no es difícil, ¿verdad? Poder adquirir las cosas necesarias para to test your surroundings, right? In order to keep everything safe, right? If you're going to do it, right, you're going to make your testings around, you can go to the health department. Go to the health department so you can get the radiological bags, right? So that way you can keep everything into radiological bags and ask them how much it's gonna be for, right, to get rid of it, right? Because some of the disposals cannot go into the garbage, into the normal garbage. It goes into a special garbage, right? And then if you cannot find out what's going on in all these things that you have prepared at home, bring them to the laboratories, right? Traiga las cosas que preparó para poder analizar sus alrededores, ¿verdad? Vaya al departamento de salud, pídale una bolsa de radioactivos, donde poner las cosas que ya no necesita si ve que todo está normal, ¿verdad? Si ve que todas las cosas le salen diferentes, llévelas al laboratorio, ¿verdad? Y para su estudio, ¿verdad? Y también pida que las incineren y, o que las terminen, ¿verdad? Cosas como esas no se pueden tener. But if you are, si usted es the kind of person, de la clase de persona who have cleaned everything around, que limpia alrededor de su casa. If you are the type of person who take all your blankets and bring your vacuum cleaner and you just do the clean up and on those things, the curtains and the doors and everything is very well and very clean. If you brush with soap and you bring the general purpose things, and if you also practice the fumigation and you put your pesticides on time, and you have exchanged your soils in your gardens, and if you repair your house on time, and if you bring everything together, the joints, the plumbing, the electricity, the water, the gas, and everything, if you keep and close all the open spaces using the foam, right, in order to prevent things to come inside of your house, right? If you check your roof also, in order to check and prevent that everything is very well and very, very well covered, that will protect you, because those things are prevention, right? And by preventing, right, you have your health in your hands. Y le digo que si usted es de las personas que limpia su casa, que lava sus cobijas, que quita el polvo de todos lados, que barre, trapea y usa la vacuum cleaner para limpiar regularmente como debe ser, that you are in good hands. I'm very sure that you are living in a very nice place. If you boil your dishes, and if you go to the health department to find out recipes to cook in the right way, which is the best way to do it, right? A lot of people say, well, I just cook in the way my mother or my dad have taught me to do it, right? Mucha gente dice, yo creo que yo aprendí de mi mamá, de mi papá, las formas de cocinar en mi casa. But how good there are, right? There are something very important to check, right? If you go to the dietitian, right, and ask them to come and help in your house and teach you and the clean lines and all the things that they ought to have in order to prevent casualties, right? Si va usted con el dietólogo y le hace un appointment para que venga a su casa y le explica cómo se hacen las cosas en la cocina, then the dietitian will come and tell you and explain to you which are the temperature of the freezers, which is the temperature of the juice boxes, what is a refrigerator, what is a tall box, what is a freezer, right? And there are so many kinds of refrigerations, right? If you have a refrigerator and you don't know what kind of refrigerator, maybe you are eating your food spoiled. We don't know for how long, right? And therefore, be careful when you purchase refrigerators. Be careful when you purchase ovens, right? And grills and all kinds of things, because if the food is not cooked appropriately, right? Porque si las cosas no están cocinadas apropiadamente y no están preservadas como se requiere, obviously that you're gonna get sick. Obviamente se va a enfermar, right? And by keeping eye on all these details, you can always go to the health department and show them your need to learn all the things all over and all over again, right? Y el departamento de salud es el que le puede guiar en decirle a cómo son que se cocinan las comidas, cómo es que, para qué se usan los refrigeradores, las cajas para descongelar, ¿verdad? Las cajas de refrigeración para las verduras, la caja para congelar, right? For how long you can keep all these things in your refrigerator? For how long can you have your raw meats in the freezer, right? And the health department will come and help you, or they will tell you all these little details, right? Entonces, el departamento de salud te puede explicar acerca de las temperaturas para cada cosa, right? A lot of people, I'm very sure that sometimes they go and they purchase vegetables and they have them in the refrigerator one day. And the next day they go and see, oh my God, these vegetables are dead, right? And it's very true because it was not a chill box, right? It was not a produce box, right? It was not the appropriate thing for it, right? But even though we believe that we are all enough, y a pesar de que pensamos que somos suficientemente grandes, dije, and by watching, we have already learned everything, y que por haber mirado, ¿verdad? Nosotros hemos aprendido, we have the responsibility, tenemos la responsabilidad to go and get the right information for once. Tenemos la obligación de ir por, de una vez por todas por la información correcta, and that way we can prevent casualties. Por eso podemos prevenir cosas, ¿verdad? And I was very interested in to tell you all these things, right? Yo estaba muy interesada en hablarte de todas estas cosas because a lot of people, right, at home, they happily cook things and they happily have things and they happily go and put things, I don't know for how many hours and they go and put everything on the freezer and eventually they throw everything outside and eventually they go and eat the stuff again. And I mean, it's fine, right? Depends on the temperature of the kitchen, right? But I'm very sure that by going to the health department, you can learn, right, how to do your cookings, right, and how to prevent, how to draw a menu, right, cómo diseñar un menú, right, and go with your doctor, right, so they can the dietitian, right, and so they can guide you into how to do all these things, right. In regards to the microbiology and the labs that you're working on, eventually we're going to have to need one stage lab in each one of our houses, right? Yo pienso que as we've been having all these kind of things, we're going to have to learn, right? Vamos a tener que aprender y tener one stage lab en la casa, right? So we can keep on testing all over around. So we can keep on testing everything, our clothes, the kitchen. So you can learn how to do all these things. Para que usted aprenda y haga rutinas en su casa. You might test your neighbors. You might charge for it. So as you go to school and learn all these things, that it can be your hobby, right? Y tal vez podría convertirse en su pasatiempo favorito. Hacer exámenes, ¿verdad? De los whereabouts microorganisms around your neighbors and make some money, right? ¿Qué puedes hacer, verdad? Tal vez ir alrededor después de que aprendes en tu casa, ¿verdad? Ir alrededor de la casa de tus vecinos y hacer también exámenes de los microorganismos que hay. Y se puede convertir en un pasatiempo lucrativo, ¿verdad? Pues vamos a despedirnos. Yo también he puesto, ¿verdad?, mis plegarias por causas espirituales, ¿verdad? Porque we also have the clinical pastorship. También nosotros nos interesa mucho la clínica pastoral. And to give hope, para poder tener una esperanza y despertar la chispa, and to wake the spark of the hope which brings from the very inside of us, que trae desde dentro de nosotros healing power from the Lord, right? Que trae el poder de salud que viene de Dios. Y le pedimos por el país y por todo el mundo, right? Le pedimos a Dios por todo el país y por todo el mundo. Nos unimos a las oraciones del Papa, ¿verdad? Y de todos los hombres santos de esta tierra. We join the Pope and all the holy people from this, all the men and women, ¿verdad? From all this world, and to the Lord can come and help us out with this test, right? Con esta clase de microorganismos que nos afectan a todos. Que la pase muy bien, ¿verdad? Y nosotros también estamos aquí. Ya nos dimos cuenta que en Houston hay como 15 casos de coronavirus, ¿verdad? Y le estamos pidiendo a Dios para que puedan sanar, ¿verdad? Pues muchas gracias, buenas noches. Y estamos hablando. Thank you very much for your attention. Let us talk next time.